Let's pretend like I don't film all my videos in one day. Guess who went thrifting? Oh, I spent a little bit too much. But it's fine. Who loves thrifting? I love thrifting. Let's go. I do these videos really differently sometimes. Like, sometimes I just talk about them, I don't try them on. Sometimes it's a lookbook, sometimes it's a bit of both. And so, I've decided I'm just gonna go through them now, and I'll film some modeling clips later. So if I say things like, oh, I'm really excited about the fit of this, and then in the other clip I'm like, whoa, it looks like shit, we'll see why. This I really fucking loved, but I'm not fucking Ashley, so I can't alter shit. I don't even know how to sew. I don't own a sewing machine. I barely own a fucking needle and thread. But look at the fucking buttons. Like, how cute. This makes me feel like I'm so really like posh and upper class, and I love it. But like I said, I need like a little bit more leg to be shown. So I'm a little bit disappointed. This was $8.99, but it's all good. It's also the softest thing, and it's Hobbs, which I think is a good brand. Hobbs London, yeah, it's the softest thing. There was a stripy t-shirt, who would have known? This is grey and navy, I want to say. Says the colourblind. I could be so fucking wrong, it's probably like red. It is an M&S top. It's size... doesn't say. Must be like an 8 or a 10. I feel like it's a 10 because I'm an 8 and it looks like quite baggy. But you know, this and just jeans, hell yeah. The softest thing. I love that most of this stuff is just soft and like doesn't even feel worn. This I'm really excited about. I tried this on already because I was going to wear it for a date, and then I realised it was a Netflix and chill date, and it's probably a bit too much to wear for a Netflix and chill date, but like short bodycon dress in black with some long ass lines. I thought it was a bit too long, and then I tried it on, it actually isn't long at all, and I bought that in a size 8, and I think I paid £3 for this, but I'm not 100% sure because like I said, I took the label off, but yeah. One of my faves. Then there was this shirt from Mango, and I saw it in the shop and I looked at it and I wasn't 100% sure and I put it down, but then my friend Molly was on the other side of the shop when I was looking at it, so she didn't see me look at it. And then a little while later, so she was like, oh my god, it's in your size, look. And I was like, I already saw it, I was gonna pick it up, I wasn't sure. And then I thought, it's gotta be, you know, if we both saw it and we both thought about it, it's meant to be, so I got it. But I'm not really a shirt person. I'm hoping once I steam this, it will obviously look better. I say steam, I mean iron. It's got makeup stains on it. Oh no, whatever will we do? But yeah, it looks a bit see-through, so I'm thinking of like a cute bralette or just a white nude bra. Or a white vest top, that'll look cute. And then with like, oh, that skirt, that'll look cute, that'll look so cute. It's gonna stop recording again, aren't you? You're gonna stop recording again. Ah. No, you're not gonna stop recording. This is the one thing that I'm mainly scared of because it looks short as fuck. If it was a dress, I wouldn't feel as bad because I could just wear shorts underneath it with tights and it wouldn't like give me a camel toe, but it's a play suit. So if it's too short, it will literally just be like in me. I really should have taken the bralette off, but that's just so much effort. It's from Topshop, size 8. And I paid £4.50. But it feels so nice. And if this does fit, which like I said, I really don't think it will. This dress is from Warehouse and it is the most classy dress I think I've ever freaking owned. It's grey with like kind of, I don't know how to explain it, like different shades of grey. And it's an 8 and I thought it looked a bit big, but I have tried this one on as well because I was really excited about it. And it's like I said, a bit long, but it does actually fit me quite well. This I paid £5.50 for, and I just love the way it fits, and oh, I wish I could alter it to be a little bit shorter, but it just gives me so many like office vibes, and I low-key love it. Next are khaki green trousers from River Island. They are a size 14, they are miles too big for me, but I'm hoping that I could maybe like, tie them a bit, you know, tighter and they'll be fine, but this is literally Kim Possible vibes. I can't go over how much I love this. I have no idea what I'm gonna wear with this. My phone is pinging. I have no idea what I'm gonna wear with this, but I fucking love it. This thing is from H&M, and at first I thought it was in the men's section and it was just like a large t-shirt, which it possibly still could be. I don't actually know, but it says it's a size small and it was £4, and I'd wear it as like with knee-high socks and little boots, or thigh-high boots, just like a cute t-shirt dress, and it's so soft. I think this is the comfiest thing I have ever freaking owned. Last but not least, we have a t-shirt that I spent £2 on, two whole pounds, and it says, hello. Is it me you're looking for? This looks a bit small, but it is a small. I just thought it was really freaking cute. And yeah, I love it, I love it a lot. For some reason, I am going thrifting very, very often. And if you like these videos, please let me know. Otherwise, I'm really doing them for my own personal gain. Let me know what your favorite item out of the ones I showed you were, and I'll see you when I see you. Please work. Why do you stop recording?